Praise God, thank God for Jesus, thank God for everything that he has done for us. Very importantly, the access he has granted us to the presence of God, to the throne of God, that we can get in and get out at will. We are going to read Ephesians chapter 3, and I'm reading verse 12. Ephesians 3, 12. In whom we have boldness and access with confidence through faith in him. Enter into the presence of God. Now, today I am actually talking exclusively to the person who is a child of God, the one that is born again, the one that is filled with the Spirit of God, the one that is walking in the ways of God, the one that is willing to be and is actually obedient to God as best he or she can. Yes, mistakes are made, no doubt about that. But then I am talking about the person who has purposed in his or her heart, I belong to God and I remain with God. That is the person that I am talking about today. That is the person that I am talking to today. You have free access. You have boldness to enter the throne of, you know, the throne of God should be very, not just mysterious, but also very frightening, very frightful, because that is the presence of God. But Jesus has given us boldness. The day he died on the cross, the veil of the temple was torn open. Not the entrance of the temple, the entrance to the place where the ark was. Where you had the testimonies of God, where you had God appearing in the midst of the cherubim. That veil was torn open and everybody could see through. That was some, well, sacrilege, as it were, in the context of the Jews. But that was God revealing himself to men and letting men know that because of the sacrifice of Jesus, the door is open. You can come in. You have the boldness to come in. I want to tell the child of God, don't hang around outside. Father, please, no, get inside. It is time to enter. We are not supposed to live that beggarly life. The so-called prayer of pleading and, oh, that is all the prayer. Every day you are pleading and pleading. And you know some story? We plead the blood of Jesus. I don't know where that one is found in the scripture. Pleading the blood of Jesus. You enter into the throne of God with boldness because there is access that has been given by Jesus. You are not meant to be outside pleading some blood. Jesus has already opened the door and says, enter. So what are you pleading? Instead of entering, you are hanging out there and pleading and pleading, and finally you say, I prayed for 1 year, God didn't answer. Did you pray? Did you enter there? He said, we have boldness to enter into the throne of God to obtain mercy in the times of need. When you have necessity, walk in there. It is open to you as a child of God. It does not take anything to be a child of God. You also can have that access today if you are willing to be born again. If you are willing to allow Jesus to be the Lord and Savior of your life. But thank God for the child of God who knows that he has access. Because by this access, you receive everything that pertains to your life. You are begging too much. We have lived a life of begging for too much. Because it says, in the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. Who entered there? Because this is the question that you are going to answer to yourself or for yourself. If you have entered into the presence of God, you should have gotten fullness of joy. Have you gotten the fullness of joy? That is the question. Who can say, I have the fullness of joy? That is the person who can also say, I have entered into the presence of God. Have you? Because this is not a matter for theory. I've often said that the scripture is not theoretical. It is completely practical in every sense of it. So is this practical for you? Do you enter into the presence of God? And how could you say, I went into the presence of God? You came out crying. The presence of God, where there is fullness of joy. There are so many things we have instructed ourselves, unfortunately, to say and to admit that are terrible. But know what the scripture says? As a man thinks in his heart, so is he. If the thinking of your heart is that in the presence of God, you can't get what you want, too bad. because you will almost certainly not get what you want. But the person who knows in his heart that he has free access, it has been opened up by Jesus, and that he should enter there boldly, and you are entering where there is fullness of joy, you cannot come out empty. You will come out with the fullness of joy. And I am going to pray for all of us today. And as the time I want to pray, you lay your hands either on your chest or on your forehead. I am going to pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, everyone that is your child, even the one who did not know, may knowledge come now, may understanding come, that the access to your throne is open to them at all times. And they must enter with boldness, not with fear and trepidation, not shaking, not begging, not crawling, but coming directly and obtaining everything for their lives. And Lord, as the mental orientation changes, so will it be replaced with the full knowledge of the boldness to enter at any time, wherever and whenever there is need. And they will obtain mercy for everything that is troubling their lives, for everything that they need for their lives. In Jesus' name. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with you now and forevermore. Amen.